Hi, I'm Walt Batansky, and welcome to the 1 Minute Lease Clause. Today's clause is the right to audit. Now, when the landlord has the right to pass through operating expenses, sometimes it will say that the tenant has the right to audit. Sometimes it'll be completely silent on it. When it does say that the tenant has the right to audit, the landlord usually tries to make it as expensive and painful as possible and give the tenant the shortest amount of time possible to do it. So they're going to give you a statement sometime after the end of the year. They usually have a lot of latitude when they do that. And you've got maybe 30 days to object. And if you don't object, then all of the charges are valid. That doesn't work for a tenant. You need to be able to inspect the books. And by the way, sometimes it'll say you can only inspect the books on the premises. Well, welcome to the electronic age. Everybody has a digital copy. They can send your accountants the digital statement. Sometimes it will say that you can't use somebody who's working on contingency. So you can't hire your advisors to only get paid if they find errors. So again, that limits you and forces you to pay high hourly rates. And many times it'll even say that it has to be a CPA firm or a nationally recognized CPA firm. No, the landlord shouldn't care. Anybody should be able to do it. Your bookkeeper should be able to inspect them if they want to. So you want to say that you have the right to do it, that you can hire whoever you want to do it, and that the landlord will provide an electronic copy. And usually if they're committing, you know, if they've charging you inappropriately, you should be able to find those charges anytime, but it sure shouldn't be a very tight window. It should give you plenty of time to ask questions, let them verify that, so you can dispute them if you need to. That's your 1 Minute Lease Clause for today.